So, my dear students, these type of these are types of oscillators that we can see here. So, that is the circuit diagram of tuned collector oscillator. Here you can see that there is a tank circuit. That is the part of the tank circuit. That's the tuned oscillator, known as the tuned oscillator, and that is the part where you can tune. Okay, and after giving the switch out there, that is the tuned collector oscillator. It is known as collector oscillator because there is a BJT amplifier here, and you know that has been connected with the collector part of the BJT. That is the collector, that is known as the base, and that is the emitter. And in that part of the BJT, that is the amplifier stage, and that is the part, again the another part, that is the just like a part that we can see the voltage divider, voltage divider bias transistor circuitry, okay, where there is a VCC here. But in that kind of a VCC, where the resistor or RC here, you can replace the RC through the tank circuit. That is the here is certainly the V input, and here we can find out the V output in general kind of voltage divider bias circuitry. So in that kind of sense, in that part, there is a tank circuit that is that consists L1 and L2, and that's two inductors. That first inductor is connected with the base, and second inductor and capacitor tank circuit. The total is known as the tank circuit, and that is the determinatory, or that is the main thing in a tuned collector oscillator, that it creates the oscillations, and also it is dependent on certain frequency. Okay, if you make it variable, so you can vary the frequency. If you make any kind of thing L1 or C1 as variable, vary cap, you can use vary cap here, then it will be a variable frequency generator or variable frequency oscillator, and that can be governed as by these resonance frequency equation, that is F equal to 1 by twice pi root over L1 C1. That means that is the L1 and C1 part is the main tank circuit, and this tank circuit part, that is the tank circuit part, as you can see here, and this tank circuit part, that is the frequency, that is the main resonance frequency, and for this it operates, and that is the oscillatory part of it. And the another part is the amplification part. As you can see, in an oscillator, there is a tank circuit, there is an oscillator, and there is a positive feedback, that is the feedback path. So the three things are very common here. So it is an oscillator. So another oscillator, we move on to the next oscillator, that is Colpitts oscillator, known as Colpitts oscillator, same as the previous one, but there are certain changes here. There is no capacitor used here. That is the important part. There is no capacitor on the tank circuit, but there are capacitor gang that has been used. There is a tank circuit that has been, that is not the tank circuit in the previous part, it is a collector part. But here I can say one thing. It is also in the collector part, but it is onto the positive feedback path. Here you can see that is the positive feedback path. Here they use a tank circuit, that is C1, C2. Okay, these two series C1, C2. And as you know that if it is series, so C1, C2 has been calculated as parallel resistor circuit, just like that. If the combination of a series capacitor as C1 and C2, then that can be calculated as parallel. Just we calculate as the equivalent resistance in the parallel connection. That is CT is equal to C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. And the total circuit, the tank circuit, is that, not the previous one we have studied before in the tuned oscillator. But here we have used an RF choke. Choke means the radio frequency choke. That has been used to control the cutoff frequency. So if we just put the value of a choke in certain high frequency, so that can limit it to the high frequency. And if anything, that can be used as a limiter also in choke. same voltage divider bias configuration, but in the resistor here we have used the RF choke, and for that part there is a positive feedback that we have connected to the input part, that is probably known as the input part, and that is the V output path as you can see here. But the C1, C2 and L, that is the part of the tank circuit that I have told you before, the tank circuit TC. So in that part, that is the part of frequency generation, and that is the governing frequency generation calculation, that is the calculation type V output and VA feedback, that is the feedback voltage, that is the feedback voltage in the C2 path, and this feedback voltage has been fed into the input section. Okay, so that is the basic of the oscillator that you can see here. Again, the oscillator, Hartley oscillator, it is quite same as the previous one, but what is the difference between these two? Colpitts oscillator, in Colpitts oscillator, as far the C concerns, to make you can remember it, that can I say, but the thing is that here they used capacitors, as capacitor gangs has been used to produce the feedback voltage and also to use as a tank circuit part. But here the combination just opposite to it. In Hartley oscillator we just remove the L part with the C and C with the L. Here you can see in the tank circuit there are the two L1 and L2 parts, that means that is the part of series inductors that has been connected with the parallel of the capacitor C, and that is the tank circuit oscillation, tank circuit frequency, that is F equal to 1 by 12 by root over C LT. What is total inductor LT? LT means L1 plus L2 plus 2M. What is 2M? 2M is the mutual inductance. Whenever we add two inductors in series connections, that will be the addition of the inductance plus the mutual inductance, that means L1 into L2, that is the mutual inductance M, that has been denoted as M. So the equation will be L1 plus L2 is equal, L2 plus twice M equal to LT, the total inductance. And that is in that part of the thing, in L1 part you get the V output in that point, and the feedback voltage has been created in the L2 part, and this part has been fed back to the input section, the same connections as before, but there is a change in the capacitor and inductor. If you put a capacitor in Colpitts oscillator, just remove it and give the inductance onto the charge and replace it, then you will get Hartley oscillator. The RF choke is quite similar to these two, and you can see there is a quite similar part in the Colpitts oscillator. There is no capacitor here, but there is an exception. There we use a capacitor, that is the exception in that part. There we use a capacitor. So that is the end of the Hartley oscillator. Now we are heading towards the crystal oscillator, and what is the characteristics of the crystal oscillator? Here it is quite similar to the Colpitts oscillator, that is quite similar to the Colpitts oscillator, but here we have used a circuit Y that is gonna be the combination of this, the CMLRC. This kind of a combination has been used here, and that is the crystal oscillator. The all of the connections are same as the Colpitts oscillator, but remove the inductance part in the Y circuit, the Y, and just replace it like that. That is a CM as a capacitor and LRC as a series LRC circuit. So that is the formation of a crystal oscillator. I hope you will understand this. We will go through to the next lectures to understand more about oscillators and tuned amplifiers.